We are gonna make this do this.
That's good.
Hey guys, so this video is a clip from a full tutorial within the free Spotlight mini course on how to create and design video content for your brand. Go to pareditsc.com/createvideo or click the link in the description to check out the course outline. All right, so next I'm gonna show you how to animate graphics within Premiere Pro and pop anything on screen that you want to show. So with our subscribe button here, it just shows up, you know, from not being there to just appearing. So I wanna make it pop on screen. I wanna make it so while people are watching, they kinda have a small distraction of this little thing, a little call to action that I want them to do. So to do that, I'm gonna go to the beginning of my clip and I want it to just like pop in from the center. So I'm gonna click on motion and I'm gonna notice that there's this little crosshair like right in the center of the file. So I'm gonna go ahead and click and drag that crosshair and put it right in the middle of the actual graphic because I want it to pop in from the center of itself. I don't want it to pop in from the center, you know, of like this area or this area. I just want it to pop in from the center of itself. So to start animating, I'm gonna keyframe scale. So at the beginning of my clip, I'm gonna click on this little stopwatch, create a keyframe, and that's the size that I want it to start at. And then I'm going to use my mouse wheel and just scroll one frame, two frame, and I'm going to make it bigger. So I'm just gonna type in 90. So now the graphic gets bigger. And then I'm gonna go 1, 2, 3, 4 frames with my mouse wheel. So in total, I've traveled 6 frames. And I'm gonna go back to 80. So what I did is when we play it, you'll see that the image like pops on screen. Bam, just like that. So it pops on screen and I think I kind of want to make it pop a little faster. So I'm gonna shorten the frame gaps. So let's scroll in one frame and we're gonna drag this keyframe here, just snaps right to it. And then from the other frame, I'm gonna scroll in 1, 2, 3, let's do 3. And I'm gonna snap that there. So when it pops on screen, bam, it's nice and quick. So it's a small little distraction, gives you a call to action, gives a call to action to your audience, and they know that they can subscribe. And so I'm just gonna go ahead and hold command or control and press D, and it can just fade off. So it pops on just like that. And then as it goes on, it lasts, and then it just fades off. So instead of popping on screen, we can also make it slide on screen. So I'm going to click on the keyframe icon for scale again, and I'm just going to delete all existing keyframes, continue, and I'm going to adjust the position now. So I'm just going to create a keyframe, and I'm going to drag it off screen. Let's drag it over here. So I just dragged it barely off screen. You can see I'm messing with the X coordinate here and kind of like hiding it off screen. So I'm just going to take it off screen and I'm going to put this keyframe at the beginning of the clip. And then from the beginning of the clip, I'm going to make it animate maybe 1, 2, 3. Let's do 3 frames. And then I'm going to bring it in by dragging X and then put it where it should end up. So now when I play this animation, it will just slide in. So it slides in pretty quick. I'm going to actually extend it another, let's see. Let's do like 1, 2, 3, maybe 2. So we're gonna do 5 frames total for the animation. And it's just gonna slide in just like that. All right, so we made this slide in from the side. We can make it slide in from the bottom. We can make it just fade in normally. So I can also just make it fade in while it's sliding. So I just did Command or Control D and put a little crossfade on that. So it fades in as it moves. I hope you guys learned something today as I had a lot of fun teaching it. Please remember to give this video a thumbs up if you liked it and be sure to subscribe for more videos just like this one. My goal is to help at least one person take the leap into the greatest profession in the world of videography. And you guys sharing this video would mean so much to me. Go ahead and leave a comment down below. If you have any questions, I'll definitely get back to you. And yeah, thanks guys. See you in the next one. Hey guys, to learn more about how to create and design video content for your brand, check out the free Spotlight mini course right now by going to ParEdits.com/createvideo. Or you can check out the link in the description down below.